This video is sponsored by Squarespace. Whether you need a domain, website, or online store, make it with Squarespace. Growing up, I remember spending a lot of time in the school library. I was your stereotypical bookworm slash computer nerd. While most 8-year-olds were spending first grade playing Foursquare or kickball on the playground, I was indoors, usually reading or typing. Computers, you see, they absolutely fascinated me, the internet in particular. I remember wanting to grow up and make computer games for a living, or at least something that involved computers, but nobody around me seemed to know anything about them. So inevitably, I took to the school library to see if I could find some kind of instruction. I was born in 1990, which essentially means that I was the last generation to use the card catalog system, and also the first to use the online one. In my school's library, the section on computers was, well, lacking, to say the least. There just wasn't a lot of literature on computers written for 8-year-olds back then. But I did manage to find this, a handy-dandy book called Make Your Own Web Page, A Guide for Kids, by Ted Peterson and Francis Moss. This book was gospel to me at 8 years old. I checked it out again and again and again. I practically owned it. I carried it everywhere I went. I even had a spiral-bound notebook where I would handwrite anything and everything the book could teach me about web design. Yep, that's how nerdy I was. Most kids doodled in their notebooks, but I was busy coding. Laptops weren't really portable or affordable back then, so I used pencil and paper to write down experimental code during class. And then I'd type it all out on our family's Windows 95 machine once I got home. I started thinking about that old book a couple months ago, and I managed to track down a copy for the purpose of revisiting a piece of my childhood. You guys seem to dig that. Obviously, I eventually went the whole video route later in life, but I was interested in seeing how much coding knowledge I had retained in the intervening 20 years. Before I opened the book back up again, I decided to turn on my computer and try to recreate my very first web page. It's been a long time, but it was neat to see just how easily some of this stuff came back to me. For instance, opening Notepad to use as the HTML text editor. I must have done this hundreds of times back then. I remembered that it was necessary to start every web page with the letters HTML in coding brackets to let the computer know what kind of code I was writing in. Then came the header code, where I would give my web page a proper title. This was what you would see at the top of the web page when viewing it in an internet browser. The end of each string of code required an end bracket to let the computer know that part was finished and I was moving on to something else. Those end brackets were very important. Missing even one meant throwing the entire code in disarray. After the header came the body of the actual site, and this is where things got fun. Whatever I put here would be displayed on the page itself for everybody to see. I could type out a simple sentence like this, or I could get crazy and change the size of the font, the position. I could italicize, underline, or bolden it. I could even make bullet points if I wanted. That was like space-age technology when I was 8. Another cool thing was the ability to add images. I always liked giving my pages some pizzazz, so even the strange-looking code for this came back to me instantly. I also remembered how to hyperlink, those clickable words that take you from one web page to another. It all seems quite archaic in retrospect, but back then, being the only second grader in my school who knew how to do this made me feel like Tesla, although I likely hadn't even heard of him, but you get what I mean. Probably the hardest thing for me to remember how to make was tables, and I remember this task was not for the faint of heart. If your data set was fairly extensive, it was easy to go cross-eyed, trying to keep each row and column straight. I remember struggling a lot with this back then, and it turns out that that had not changed a couple of decades later. So as a fun little challenge, I decided to make a calendar of all the plans my wife and I had made for that month. It took me a while, probably way longer than 8-year-old me would have needed, but I managed to put something fairly impressive together, at least if you're the book's target demographic. All of this got me thinking about how much the internet, and indeed life, has changed in the past 20 years. This little web page, which seemed so complicated and impressive back in 98, is laughable now. Squarespace, the web design platform sponsoring this video, has templates that are about a million times more elegant than this, and they can be made in minutes with literally no coding experience. Yes, the internet has come a very long way, and I guess I have as well. I was a quirky kid who probably had very few friends, but now I'm a grown man with a host of friends and family. I've got a beautiful and loving wife, and I've got this weird YouTube thing that now around 250,000 people watch me on, which is still ridiculous. The stuff looked and seemed like rocket science to me back then, but now it seems so simple. at least compared to the more complicated evolution that's now being used. Likewise, in life, stuff that seems huge and difficult and amazing and complicated in childhood become just regular everyday occurrences of adulthood. As a kid, my biggest challenges were making it to the end of the school day and taking care of a few chores around the house, but now that I'm older, I have a vast list of responsibilities that I need to get done. As a kid, if I struggled to complete a particular task, an adult could always step in and lend a helping hand. But now that I am an adult, if I struggle and can't complete a task, there are very serious consequences. People rely on me to make things happen and to get things done. There are no grown-ups to step in and fix things if I mess something up. I am the grown-up. And you know something? That's good. Responsibility is a freight train that tears through the tracks of time, sending the only warning horn of, ready or not, here I come. Anyway, back on point. The book in question promises to help you make your own place in cyberspace. And years later, the place I ended up making turned out to look a lot different. The place we set out to make in life rarely ends up the way we originally envisioned. But that's not a sign of failure. It's a sign that we've gained greater perspective, and we've freed ourselves from the chains of childhood expectations. Somebody tweeted me in November that they had been in a slump, but that my videos had helped pull them out of it. I'll share with you what I said to him. Life ebbs and flows. The real trick is finding a way to move with it. Anyway, I'm supposed to like hook this back into the sponsor. So if you want to try your hand at website design, but don't want to learn HTML code like 8-year-old Austin did, head to squarespace.com for a free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/AustinMcConnell to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Is it just me, or does this video have like a really weird range of emotions? I think I'm going to make some goofy stuff pretty soon because I've been way too mushy on here recently. See you guys.